friends, welcome to my channel Sushant Chess Wise. Today is the third lesson and we will be trying to see how the remaining pieces move. So in the last lecture we saw the king, queen and the rook movements. Today we will be seeing how the bishop, knight and pawn are able to move. So let's start with the bishop. Let's place the bishop on the middle of the board and now let's see. So the bishop is able to move only diagonally. So we saw that rook is able to move straight, queen is able to move straight and diagonally both, bishop is able to move only diagonally. So we see that there are two bishops. Standing on different color in the beginning of the game. So the bishop standing on this black square will move only on the black squares, and the bishop standing on the white square will move only on the white squares. So let's see how the bishop is able to move. So suppose the bishop is standing on the black square, it can move only diagonally. So from d4, see, it can go diagonally up here, okay, to the right. Then it can go diagonally down, it can go diagonally up here to the left and diagonally down right. Okay, so we can say it can move cross, bishop is able to move cross or slanting when we teach the games. So bishop is able to move only in this way. Okay, let's see like the previous example where all the bishop can go and let's see what are its possibilities. So let's say this square, this bishop standing on white is only able to move on the white squares. So let's see this square, can the bishop move here? So the answer will be no, because bishop can come only till here diagonally and maybe later on here, but in one move it cannot reach here. Okay, let's look at this square, can the bishop move here? Again the answer is no. The bishop is unable to move straight. Okay, let's look at this square. Okay, the bishop is able to go there. It's just one step away and bishop is moving diagonally. Okay, so the bishop is able to move from here to here, here to here, from this diagonal up here and down here till the last square. Okay, that is all about the bishop. Same way like we discussed other pieces, bishop is also able to capture the piece in its same way, the way it moves. So bishop can capture any piece diagonally. Okay, now we will look at the knight. Usually the knight is a complicated piece when it comes to kids. So knight takes some time to understand. One of the simplest ways is we tell them that the knight will move 2.5 steps, that is 2 steps, first 2 steps straight and then left or right to any direction. So let's place the knight in the middle of the board. So we will see from its place, we will count here. For kids it's best to start 0 here. So we go 1, 2 and to the left. So 1, 2 and half. So the third is going to the left or to the right. So let's see here, 1, 2 and half. So the knight can move 1, 2 and half. So one more thing noted about the knight, so it is always making an L shape. Okay, knight is able to make an L shape. Again here also same. Another quality of the knight is it will always change its color. Now it stands on black, from black it always goes to white. Let's see another side. So always it is moving, first 2 steps are straight. So 1, 2 and half. So 1, 2 and half. So let's see, 1, 2 and half. Okay, so knight is able to cover 8 squares. So we saw 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This is 1, 2 and half. So knight is able to go here. Let's look at this square. 1, 2 and half. Okay, and there are 2 more squares left. 1, 2 and half. And again, 1, 2 and half. So we can see all the surrounding places where the knight is able to move. So these are the 8 squares where the knight can move. So for showing the kids, sometimes we can place the opponent pawns and teach them this way, so that they come to know this is the range. These all the places are there. Wherever I am pressing the pawns, the knight is able to attack. So these are the 8 places where the knight is able to attack at a time. Okay. Now another very interesting example what we can do. So for the knight captures the same way. Let's test in the corner. When the knight goes to the corner, it has very less squares as compared to before. See, here it's 0. So 1. 2 and half. So 1, 2 and half. So let's try again. Let's change the direction. Now from here 0, 1, 2 and half. Here. So from here again 1, 2 and half. From here again 1, 2 and half. Okay. Let's learn one more thing. Let's say there are two black pawns placed this way. The knight will move over the pawn. Knight can jump over any piece. So we see one happening here, 2 and half. It can capture this pawn. Okay. So that is how the knight has jumped over the pawn, but it will not capture the pieces which are there in between. It will just capture the piece which it goes till at the end. Okay, so one practice we can do with the kids is place the knight at the edge of the board, keep pieces which are in relation this way, and practice. See, knight is able to move 1, 2 and half. See, the knight can capture the pawn. Okay, then we see knight is able to move again 1, 2 and half. It's able to capture this pawn as well. Now knight is able to see move 1, 2 and half. It's able to capture the bishop. And finally knight is able to move 1, 2 and half. It's able to capture the rook. So that's about the knight. This is how the knight moves. We can place the knight anywhere and test the child if he's able to understand. So points to remember is knight moves in L shape. It always changes the color of its square. From white it goes to black, from black it goes to white. So now finally let's look at the pawn. Pawns are always placed on the second rank. The pawn is able to move 2 steps in the beginning. The pawn can move 2 steps from its starting point. It can also move 1, but maximum is 2. Another thing about pawn is pawn will move straight. Okay, so next will be once it has moved, so it can move only 1 step. Again straight, again straight. Okay, there is a strange thing, peculiar thing about the pawn is that it captures differently from the way it moves. So let's see. Let's say if the pawn is here. Okay, so it cannot capture a piece in front of it. Okay, the pawn will have to capture diagonally. It goes diagonally and 1 step ahead. So it can capture diagonally. Same way, let's have the pawn here. The pawn can capture the knight diagonally. The pawn cannot capture straight. So if there is a black pawn here, position is like this. White pawn can capture the black pawn like this, and same way the black pawn is coming ahead from its position, so the black pawn is able to also recapture the white pawn. So the black pawn is coming this side. Okay, so that is it about the movement of the pawn. So we have learned bishop, knight and pawn today, and in the upcoming lectures we will be discussing other qualities of the pawn, and we will be seeing how to see the notation and all. Thanks for your time. Do subscribe if you like the channel.